Hi ladies, this is Amber Mellon and welcome to my channel. If you are new here, my channel is all about my journey as an entrepreneur, working for myself. I'm all about encouraging and just being positive to women who watch my channel and uplifting them, helping them to realize their talents, their gifts. So nothing but love and positivity here. You'll also see some hair, some beauty, but lately, I've been focusing on being a business owner and entrepreneur. So if you are here for a girl, then don't forget to hit that subscribe button and that notification bell so you never miss an upload from me. So today's video is bossing up your business for the holidays, okay? I'm super excited about some things that I have coming to my channel to help you guys for the end of this, to finish out the end of this year strong and to start the new year off right, whether that be with yourself, whether that be with your business, your salon, or if you have a YouTube channel. We are bossing up, ladies. We are gonna get in gear. We're gonna grind this year out. We're gonna put in the work and we're going to set some goals for ourselves, okay? So we are bossing up for the holidays. I know that it's August, but you ladies, if you haven't yet, you should be thinking about what type of things that you are going to implement with your business during the holidays, okay? So I know it's kind of annoying when we go to stores and we feel like they're just bum rushing us with all these holidays, but there's a reason why they do it. They are taking advantage of those clients who like to think ahead and get things ahead of time, and they're taking advantage of people who kind of like are procrastinators and or they're waiting for things to go on sale. There's a reason why they do it, guys. So if you haven't already, I want you to be thinking about fall. I want you to be thinking about Christmas. I want you to be thinking about Thanksgiving. If you celebrate Halloween, be thinking about Halloween. Yes, think of how you can implement the seasons and the holidays into your business to make more income, to increase your clientele, increase your business. If you have a YouTube channel, get more views. This is the time to start planning it out. So if you don't have a planner, I would advise you to get one, or journal if you don't have the money to get a planner, just something like a little book. So I have this little thing, and this is just when I have ideas come to me, I always find myself grabbing this book and jotting them down. If you ladies follow me on Instagram, you recently know that I invested in a planner for myself. I invested in the Happy Planner from Michaels, and I'm really excited about just setting goals for myself, planning out my day, my night, my week, my month, my life, so I can just be more organized and be more productive. So yes, that's the one first thing you want to do, is have something you can write and jot your ideas, your plans, and your goals down, okay? Brainstorm what kind of themed promotion that you want to implement with your business. For me, one of the things I've been thinking about as soon as before fall gets here, so I'll probably start implementing these things towards the middle end of September. You ladies know I like to do men's hair, so definitely I'm going to have some fall beers in my salon. In my area, a lot of the guys like local beers, IPAs, so that means, you know, thinking about what type of extra incentives to my salon that I can add. So one of the things that I came up with is maybe during the fall, you ladies know it gets darker in the fall, we have daylight saving times coming. So I've been thinking about doing a bros and beers night, or a beards bros and beers night, just, you know, certain things like that where you could play on words with the seasons. If you're a colorist and you're really into color, maybe you can think about something really cool like fall into color, and maybe you can play with the colors of the seasons. If you like vivid colors, you can maybe get some hair models and start, you know, doing some vivid hair colors that resemble fall. You ladies know that some women like to go darker in the fall time. So maybe you can, show some work of some really pretty balayage techniques where it's chocolate at the roots and maybe a nice autumn brown towards the ends. If you do makeup, think about some things that you can incorporate with makeup. Maybe you can give a quick mini makeover for the fall. You can introduce how to take your look from summer to fall. A lot of the fall eyeshadows, darker eyeshadows, a lot of people like burnt orangey eyeshadows for the fall. Come up with some things that you can incorporate in your business. And another thing is, whenever we think about the decor, when you go to the store, they already have everything you need for Christmas before Thanksgiving is here, okay? So you ladies know the fall is coming. So if you like to decorate your space, if you have the budget for it, you wanna already be decorating your salon, your loft, the last 2 weeks of September. You wanna already be going out, getting things, and setting the mood for fall and autumn. Cause you ladies know I'm all about visual, smell, experience, and great service, great quality haircut. So in my salon for the fall, I definitely like to focus on smell, visual, experience, just relaxation, quality customer service, and just adding little things that not everyone thinks about. So definitely gonna have some beer. Maybe you can do wine down Wednesdays. If you like to do wine in your salon, really just play with it, you guys. So your salon will be decorated for fall when September gets here, by the end of September, and you shouldn't really have to touch it until probably like after Thanksgiving. So after Thanksgiving, you definitely want to incorporate Christmas into your salon, some type of flower arrangement that's Christmassy, some type of decor that's kind of Christmassy, and you can go on Pinterest and get all kind of ideas what type of Christmas you want. Do you want a pink chic Christmas? Do you want the traditional classic red and white and green Christmas? Do you want a rustic Christmas? Do you want a grungy Christmas? Just play with it, you guys. This is the time of the year to have fun, to play around with decor, to play around with special play on words with promotions, to invite people into your salon. If you do men's hair, you ladies know that No Shave November is big. During November month, so definitely want to be thinking about retail as well. I don't know how I could forget this. So when you get retail, focus on 2 to 4 take home products that you absolutely love. Don't have too much, because sometimes when you have too many products to choose, the human brain can't process it, and then they end up not getting anything. But if you have 2 products, or no more than 4, that go-to product for that specific client, for their hair needs, yeah, especially if you're excited about it, you've used it for years and years. So if you don't have the budget yet to get retail, you definitely want to be saving any excess that you're from your sales that you're getting from your salon, and you definitely want to save that for decor, for retail, for shopping bags. Make sure you have gift cards. Don't forget that you can go on Zazzle. .com, which is my favorite website to get business cards, gift cards. You can go on Vistaprint, get you some gift cards. We want to focus on asking, okay? So years and years ago, never really liked to ask clients to buy product or retail for me. I never liked when places I've worked, they try to push selling retail on me. But I found out that when I absolutely love a product and I know this product works for a particular hair type, oh my gosh, I'm so passionate about it. I know everything about it. I know how it's going to affect the client. And a lot of times, if you don't have the product inside of the salon, you're like, if you want this product, let me know and I'll get it for you. A lot of times they're not going to get it. You know how I know? Because I'm guilty of it myself. So if you have the product there on hand for them to see it, retail it. If you have men, retail, cologne, beard oils, pomades are big. I absolutely love pomades. And for men, I only use one brand of shampoo and conditioner, and that is the Paul Mitchell Tea Tree Lavender Mint Shampoo. Is my absolute favorite. It's really good for all hair types. And so the end of September, I'm going to have my retail together. I'm going to figure out what kind of retail I have. Don't forget that in Salon Centric and Cosmoprof, they have like little gift bundles. You definitely want to take advantage of people shopping during the holidays, and you definitely want people shopping from you. If you have the budget, maybe you can come up with some gratuities for your clients, like pens, or, you know, definitely want to have Christmas cards for your clients that have support you, especially if this is your first few months opening up, or if this is your first year or second year, whatever it is, definitely want to make sure that you show your clients that you appreciate them. So, you know, create that budget, and they don't have to be expensive. You can go to Dollar Tree and get some Christmas cards. You can, you know, stick a candy cane in there. And if you go on Vistaprint and buy your own gift cards, you can even put a gift card inside of their Christmas card for, say, like $5 or $10 off their next service, and make sure you put the expiration date, like no later than January 31st, 2019, because we all know everyone spends all their money on Christmas and they're like, oh, I'm broke, I gotta re-up, I gotta save up. And they get their hair done for New Year's Eve, and then you really don't see them until like that last, like towards the end of January, beginning of February. So January is a slow month, but maybe it could be busy for you if you were to put a gift card inside of that Christmas card, $5 to $10 off, whatever you prefer, put it in that card and make sure you put the expiration date, January 30th or 31st. That way you'll be slammed like those last 2 weeks of January, or you could extend it out into February, whichever you want to do. Yes, guys, so that's what I just want to talk about. You know, make sure that you're jotting ideas down, whether you do color, makeup, hair cutting, eyebrows. I mean, there's tons of like fun things that you can do with your salon. Just like I always say, be creative, think outside the box. You know, make sure that you are, you know, always being professional, that you're educating your clients on take home, that we're upselling. That's the thing that I want to focus on this year, is really making sure that I have some goals before my day starts, before I take my first client. If you have a place for a chalkboard in your salon, make sure you're telling your clients to follow you on Instagram. Some clients don't like to be engaged on social media or do anything on social media. But if you offered a discount to say, hey, if you follow me on Instagram, you know, tag me in your pictures, I'll take $5 off your service, or, you know, I'll take $2 off your service. Hey, don't forget to leave me a review on my Google business. I'll, you know, take $5 off. You know, hey, don't forget to refer someone to me, and the next time you come back, I'll take $5 off, or whatever amount you choose to, you know, incentive to give your clients for referring you guys. Because I'm starting to realize, like, that is the best way to build your business, is from the clients that you already have. If your clients are coming back, 9 times out of 10, they absolutely love you, they love the work you do, and they're gonna be excited about referring you to others. You know, versus it might be a little harder to go up to a complete stranger and say, you know, hey, will you support my business? So definitely this year, what your goals needs to be, making sure every client you ask them, you know, for a referral, decide what type of incentive you want to give them for referring you. Ask them to leave you a review on whatever booking website you have, on you know, if your business is listed on Google. Ask them to follow you on Instagram and tag you in their pictures. You know, you can always get a rustic chalkboard and, you know, write these promotions down. Maybe take one day of the week and do like something fun. Like for me, like I said, maybe one night during the week I can do a beard and like implement beer and a haircut, or beer and a beard trim and a haircut. You know, just really get creative. Make sure your decor is inviting, warm, and nice. Not that you have to spend a lot of money, But you know, you want to be like everyone else. You want to create that type of atmosphere. You want to keep it going. If someone just went and spent money at Walmart or Best Buy or TJ Maxx for Christmas and Thanksgiving, you want them to come to you and keep that same atmosphere going. And you really want to continue to get it in their mind that they need to purchase some gifts for their family and their loved ones from you, okay? All you have to do is ask. If they say no, it's okay. If you have waxing in your salon, you know, make sure that you're asking everyone, do they want a brow wax, which is something that I need to work on. I'm guilty of. I have a wax pot in my salon and I'm not asking every female client, do they want a brow wax? So that is one of my goals to start, you know, starting now. Any little thing that you can upsell, whether it's a hair treatment, whether it's a gift certificate, whether it's brow tinting, waxing the brows, whether it's take home retail sale, whether you know you add little scalp massages or whatever, you know, any little thing that you can think of to build your ticket, guys, that's what you want to do. And you want to constantly remember to a way where you can always be building your clientele by asking your current clients for referrals, for reviews online, to tag you in their pictures, and to show them that you appreciate them. Okay, so I hope I wasn't rambling in this video. If you ladies have any more questions about what kind of things that you could do for the holidays for your business, please let me know. Of course, you ladies know if you have a YouTube channel, there's all sorts of things that you could talk about during the holidays. You just got to be making sure that you're ready to put that work in and that you're planning what the topics that you're going to talk about your channel ahead of time. And you really want to increase your frequency of posting, because this is a time where everyone's going on YouTube for wig reviews, makeup tutorials, the best makeup for the holidays, because every woman wants to look slayed and popping for the holidays. And if your channel's popping and you're bringing the energy, you're nice, you're sweet, you keep it fun, you just get to the point, I'm telling you, you're gonna grow your YouTube channel as well, okay? So yes, that's another thing I'm working on, is increasing my frequency, going back to at least 2-3 videos a week and just working it in my weekday, okay? I love you ladies. I hope you're having an awesome day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.